everybody. This is Dr. Ed Park from Recharge Biomedical, and we're starting a webinar related to lung cancer today. I'd like to start with a quick presentation, and then we're going to get into an interesting case. The symptoms of lung cancer are kind of nonspecific. I think it's more the time course that should be concerning. The symptoms are coughing, with or without blood, shortness of breath, wheezing. If some of the airways are affected, then you can get wheezing, chest pain. So for the classification of lung cancer, there's two kinds. The majority, 80%, are called non-small cell lung cancer. And these include squamous cell, adenocarcinoma, and large cell. The kind that Jackie had was a small cell. Small cell is typically considered a non-curable disease. At this time, there's really no adequate treatment for it. Hi, Jackie, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can.
Oh, perfect. So it was showing that you had a 3-centimeter mass back in July of 2009, close to the center tree of the lung. Is that correct?
Right. Yes.
Right. So at that time, the workup would have been bronchoscopy. They take a tube and look down your trachea and go to the area of the tumor and try and poke through and or biopsy a visible lesion, which was not satisfactory. But they had also, in the metastatic workup, seen that her thoracic vertebrae number 5, just below probably the shoulder blades, had a bone, what appeared to be a bone metastasis. They biopsied it. It turned out to be small cell. So obviously the tumor here, if it went to the bone, had to be small cell, so there was no longer necessary to get tissue from here. She had an MR of the brain, and that was negative at that time, and I guess they offered, but you declined whole brain radiation as a preventative measure. At that time, you were still kind of thinking about going back to work.
Right.
Yeah. So the CT of the spine showed a 4.4-centimeter lesion 2 months after the initial chest X-ray, and it had begun to compress the fecal sac and the spinal cord. So that was quickly becoming more and more symptomatic with the paresthesia.
Right. Yeah, it was within probably about a 2-week period that I went from being at work and not having any symptoms to actually not even be able to sit up anymore because the pain in my back was so bad.
Wow. So this is not, so that's why small cell, of course, so aggressive, so rapidly growing. You were stuck at home, kind of the boy in the bubble. And then it was really, I assume, a low energy, kind of a low quality of life at that time.
It was very, very poor. It was everything I could do to get out of bed and sit in a chair all day. It was, I had no life.
So that's the state of cancer treatment for this disease in small cell. We just go in and poison everything and hope that the bad guys get more poison and that the good guys will recover. But unfortunately, in April of 2010, the tumor, which had shrunk, was coming back to 2.7, and it's shown here. This is your actual film.
Right.
So had the, obviously the tumor had probably helped shrink it destroyed the spinal mat, and did that help your chest numbness?
It did.
Mass, and then a new finding was the brain metastasis. Even to the layperson, when you look at this image, it just looks like a huge cannonball here. In your, I think it's the perhaps the right parietal lobe. And at this point, you said, "Well, I don't have much to lose. I have a brain met. Time to consider what Tracy's been saying and some good news, which is why we're on this call." In August, the summer, a PET scan showed that the lesion had shrunk.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing, isn't it?
Not really what we would expect, especially if the cancer had grown after, you know, platinum etoposide. Another 4 is usually not going to be much different. It becomes resistant. But the best news of all were the metastatic disease. This just blew me away. I mean, this is you 4 months after the original cannonball in your head, and it looks pretty darn good.
Yeah. It's
so the 3-centimeter was down to this tiny remnant healing, and the other tumor was not visible anymore. And this was 4 months after.
Right.
So, I mean, tell me what you were feeling at that point. I mean, I'm sure you weren't expecting that.
I wasn't. I was just hoping at least that it would stop the bleeding, you know, that during the radiation would stop the bleeding. I wasn't expecting to get a result like that. I was absolutely amazed.
Yeah, as I'm sure 99 out of 100 oncologists, if they were on the call, would be. And how do you feel? I mean, you know how you feel. Do you feel strong?
I feel fine. You know, my energy level is back. I don't really have any kind of symptoms of having cancer. You know, I don't have the coughing, the bloody secretions. I don't have any of that. My head feels okay. I don't have any headaches. And overall, I feel good.
Hello.
Hi, Tracy.
Hi, how are you?
Good, Dr. Park. I know we haven't spoken, but we did talk about you a little bit and the fact that you had known Dr. Wilson and, you know, kind of were asking Mom to try TA65.
You know, she has that science-based mind, so she wants the facts and the proof.
Mm-hmm.
And so, yeah, she wasn't into it by any means.
And so now, looking at the before and after, she looks so young. Is that just the lighting, or does she seem healthy as she appears in the picture?
Yeah, no, she does look really young, actually. I mean, she's really involved with us.
Well, for whatever reason, you know, the brain metastasis, the tumor in her lung seemed to be well under control. And I'm sure if it stayed that way, she wouldn't mind having cancer for the rest of her life. Right? If there's no symptoms. She looks amazing. Did she get a lot of colds this winter? I know last year she couldn't even leave the house, or in 2009. Was she sick a lot?
I don't think so. No. Like, we've had a flu that's run through all the rest of the kids. She hasn't gotten it. And all the rest of us have been sick.
Is there anything else that you want to share with people who may be considering recommending this to somebody or trying it with or without cancer? I mean, what would you say to your husband?
You know, the biggest thing that I can say is, the difference between how I felt with the first chemotherapy session and the second chemotherapy session was like night and day. Taking the TA65 with the chemotherapy, I was not run down to the ground like I was the first time. If for no other reason, I would recommend it just to help the chemo. It's amazing how much different you feel. And the way that I explain it is, you keep loading your body up with this toxic substance and never giving it a chance to recover. And the TA65 helps it to, you know, recover as it's being beaten. You know, as your cells are getting beaten up, the TA65 helps to rejuvenate the good ones, which I think is very important.
It's like, so, you know, you have a hostage situation, but instead of poisoning everybody, you go in and you make everyone stronger. And the good guys do outnumber the bad guys, so hopefully your immune system figures out what it can do. And if it be divine intervention, placebo effect, I'm pretty happy with how you're turning out.
Oh, yeah, I'm very pleased. I'm very pleased. I've gotten 6 months more than what I was supposed to get, and I'm still doing okay,